Hi, I'm Sophie from the PageFly team. In today's video, I'll walk you through how to add products to Shopify and promote them effectively. We're breaking it down into three key chapters. First, we'll dive into adding your first product to your site. Then we'll talk about managing prices, inventory, variants, and meta descriptions. And we're not stopping there. We've got a special chapter on creating collections and organizing your products, plus a peek at some of the best Shopify apps designed to supercharge your product pages and skyrocket your conversion rates. Just in case you haven't set up your Shopify store yet, you can check out the description below for a link to grab your 3-day free trial and the first month with Shopify for just $1. It will only take less than 90 seconds to get your trial account ready. This link will get you straight to our Shopify affiliate page. When you open your store using our link, you're not just getting your online store off the ground, you're also giving us a huge boost. Your support keeps us going, allowing us to keep delivering awesome content and insights about the e-commerce world. Chapter 1. Let's dive straight into our main topic today, how to add products to Shopify the right way. Now, in the Shopify admin dashboard, go to Products on the left side and click on Add Product. When adding your product, make sure the title and description are clear but catchy. Let's say I'm selling a basic t-shirt. I'm gonna name it Basic Crew Neck T-shirt. In the description, highlight what makes your product, and in my case, the t-shirt stands out, like its key features and available sizes. Keep everything straightforward so shoppers can quickly grasp what you're offering. Next, it's time for photos. Pick a main image and some close-ups to show off the details. You can easily drag and drop to choose your main photo. Uploading the right file type for these images is crucial for keeping your site speedy and looking sharp. And here's a little bonus for sticking around. Check out the description for a free Shopify image size cheat sheet. It's your key to perfecting image sizes and formats for faster load times and crisper visuals. After that, don't forget to add alt text to your images. This alt text helps search engines understand what your photo is about, improving your product's visibility in search results. Consider incorporating the exact keywords or similar phrases in your alt text to make it easier for customers to find your product. For example, when I Google my product, the Basic Crew Neck T-shirts, other shops and e-commerce platforms pop up. Just a heads up about this milestone we're talking about, the top three rankings in search engines grab more than 2/3, which is 68.7% of all clicks. And a featured snippet, which basically takes the top spot in organic search results, has the highest click-through rate at 42.9%. Moving on to chapter 2, here's what we are going to cover in this chapter. But let's talk about prices first. Pricing is key when it comes to making a profit, especially with online sales. Setting a price isn't just a one-shot deal. You've got to keep revisiting and tweaking it as you go along. To nail down a retail price, there are three main steps you should follow. First up, you need to figure out your variable costs for each product. This includes stuff like materials, labor, and overhead. You want to know how much all this costs you and how many items you can pump out with it. For instance, let's say your total cost per product winds up being $14.28 after you account for everything from production to shipping. Then you gotta think about adding a profit margin. Imagine you're shooting for a 20 profit margin on top of your costs. Just remember, you still have fixed costs to cover. These are costs that stay the same no matter how much you sell, like your rent or software subscriptions. You're aiming to have your sales cover these costs too. And you gotta keep your prices competitive. If you're way pricier than your competition, it could hit your sales hard. If you wanna take the hassle out of figuring out your prices, give a product pricing calculator a shot. You can check the quick link in the description below to get started. It's super helpful for finding that sweet spot where your price is right for both making a profit and keeping your customers happy. Just play around with the numbers until you hit on a price that feels good for everyone. Back to this example, you can see here are two boxes which are price and compare at price. If you're looking to show this product as on sale at a discounted price, you can set up a compare at price right here. So for instance, if the sale price is $16, you'd enter that here. And if the original price was 19 bucks, you'd put that there. This is how the price and the compare at price are shown on the product page. In my case, I'm just going to set the original price for this example. All right, let's jump into inventory settings. Good inventory management is a must for any size business and comes packed with benefits. Zero spoilage, no dead stock hanging around, lower storage costs, better cash flow, and smooth fulfillment for quicker, cheaper shipping. Turning on Shopify's track quantity feature means Shopify automatically adjusts your stock counts with each sale, doing the hard work for you. Also, if your items have a stock keeping unit or barcode, don't forget to enter that info. Keeping your inventory precise and up to date is super straightforward. Let's say that I've got 100 t-shirts ready to go. To get that inventory number to show up here, you will need to update it in Shopify's inventory section, then update your inventory number and hit save when you're done. Simple, right? Now back to the product page, you will see that the number is shown up here. The business location shown below will indicate to Shopify that I have these 100 AT shirts at this specific spot. Remember that you can tweak and update these settings anytime, so there's no pressure. Scroll down to the shipping details. If what you've got is a digital product, feel free to skip ahead. But for those of you with physical products, you'll want to check the box that says this is a physical item. Then go ahead and enter its weight. If you want to sell globally, you'll need to select your business's country or region and then input the harmonized system code for each product you're shipping internationally. They help you steer clear of fines, delays at the border, seizure of the products, or even being told you can't bring your products into a country. Now let's talk about Shopify Variants. This feature gives you the power to customize your product listings with variations like size, color, material, or style. I'm focusing on size for the t-shirts I'm selling. I'd select size and then type in the different options available. But I'm not stopping at size. I also want to offer color choices. To do that, I just click add another option and follow the same steps. After setting up your variants, the next step is to upload images and set prices for each variation. This way, customers can see exactly what they're choosing and know the price right off the bat. Let's touch on the search engine listing preview. This is the snapshot people will see when they stumble upon your product page via Google or any other search engine. So each part of this listing should spotlight your product keyword, opting for a simple URL slug, something like basic crew neck t-shirt will do the trick just fine. This is your chance to make a solid first impression in search results, so make every word count. Click save and then your product is ready. After adding your first product, the next step is creating collections. Here is a collection example that I took from the Baboon to the Moon shop. Super neat and lively, isn't it? Really well organized too. A collection page groups products with something in common like brand or style, making it easier for customers to find what they need. Here's how to add your product to a collection on Shopify. You've got two options, directly through the collections box on the product page or using conditional text. But first, you need to create a collection. Let's take a quick run through. Click products, then collections, and hit create collection. Name it, let's say basic t-shirts. Add a description, an image, and some alt text. Now, in the collection type section, make sure to select automated first. Pick product tags and set it to is equal to, type in t-shirt and any product tagged t-shirt will automatically join the basic t-shirts collection. After saving, go back to your product, add the t-shirt tag, and save again. That's it, and you're all set. Pick the method that works best for you and take it for a spin. And don't miss out on the Shopify free trial link below to try this out yourself. Moving on to our final chapter, this is a special chapter that includes some of the best Shopify apps to kick your sales and engagement, from creating bundles apps to up to product variants app. All right, let's dive into creating bundles to ramp up those sales. By showing your customers the extra value of snagging multiple items in one go, Shopify product bundling can seriously boost your revenue and even cut down on marketing and distribution costs. Bundling isn't just a holiday thing. It's a killer strategy all year round. Here's the lowdown on the three main types. First, pure bundling. This means that you're selling items only as part of a bundle, can only get by buying the whole set. It's a take it or leave it deal. Next up, let's talk about fixed bundling. This is all about mixing and matching products that normally go solo and offering them as a bundle for a sweet deal. It's a win-win for matching vibes. Finally, price bundling. This includes bundles that come at a discount or with a little something extra. BOGO or buy one, get one deals are the classic example here, making customers feel like they're getting an awesome deal and encouraging them to buy more. You can also check out these top Shopify bundle apps to get you started. Shopify bundles this no-cost built-in app makes bumping up your average order value a breeze by letting you whip up product bundles right in Shopify. Super straightforward, no tech skills needed, with choices for product variants and real-time stock updates to avoid overselling. Release it COD form and upsells. This app boosts your conversion rate and average order value, or AOV, with a one-click cash on delivery order form. Spice it up with upsells and offers to jack up your AOV. Plus, you can dodge those fake orders with OTP phone verification and keep a close eye on your sales across platforms like Facebook and Google. In Bundler product bundles, it gets your sales climbing with discounts for buying bundles. Bundler lets you offer deals when folks buy products together, upping your average order value. From classic combos to mix match, there are loads of ways to push sales and pack in more value for your shoppers. Google surveys show that 88% of shoppers crave variety, and we've got the Shopify app picks to deliver just that. Apps like Infinite Options allows for customizable options like color swatches and drop-down menus, making it easy to add extras like gift wrapping or rush processing that to boost order value through product bundling. For product options and customizer, it's a Shopify app that elevates customization, enabling engravings to texture choices and enriching the shopping experience. It also allows for charging extra for those special tweaks, enhancing revenue while making shopping interactive and personalized. Another great app in this category is the Product Options Variant option by Avis. It breaks the Shopify variant limit, offering endless customization and giving shoppers the freedom to personalize their purchases. Its simple setup and variety of option types like text and color swatches ensure your products stand out. And that's a wrap on our guide to adding products to Shopify. We began with why Shopify is a top choice for e-commerce, moved on to setting up your account with a free trial, and showed you how to add your first product. We also detailed managing prices, inventory, and organizing your store with collections, including tips for high-quality images and compelling descriptions. Thank you for watching. If this guide was helpful, let us know by giving it a like, share, and don't forget to subscribe for more tips. Here's to the success of your online store. Until next time, happy selling.